When Apple dropped the Roman numeral X from macOS 10 and rebranded it as just macOS back in 2016, it seemed like the start of a new chapter for Apple's flagship operating system. But what if I told you that the X never actually left? You see, the X is still alive and well within macOS and has been for over 35 years. Its roots are older than macOS 10 itself. It didn't just represent the 10th version of Apple's operating system in cool Roman numeral fashion. It stood as a reminder to where macOS came from and pointed directly at what may actually be Steve Jobs' greatest accomplishment, although it's seldom recognized and didn't even happen at Apple. You may not see it on the surface, but the real core of macOS, the software that runs everything, has been hiding in plain sight all along. I'm talking about the legendary XNU kernel. This is what the X in macOS 10 really stood for, and despite Apple removing it from the OS name, it remains as a rock-solid piece of code at the core of macOS, right where it's been since macOS was an entirely different operating system altogether, an operating system known as Next Step, first released in 1988 by a company called Next, founded by Steve Jobs after Apple's board ousted him from Apple in 1985. That's right, the core of macOS was created by Steve Jobs and engineers Rich Page and Avi Tavanian in 1988, 13 years before it would be released as the foundational piece of macOS 10 in 2001. Apple wouldn't even get their hands on it until 1997. To understand where the XNU kernel comes from, we need to go back to 1985. After being ousted from Apple, Steve Jobs didn't sit still. He started Next with one ambitious goal: build the best computer that the world had ever seen. Something powerful enough to run complex research labs and high-end universities. But to do that, they needed a revolutionary operating system, one far beyond what Apple currently had at the time. So Jobs and his team created the Next Step operating system. It was sleek, advanced, and built around a completely new type of software core, the XNU kernel. A kernel is the core piece of software on a computer that allows it to interface with its hardware components. Pretty important. The XNU kernel was groundbreaking. It was a hybrid, combining the lightweight, fast communication of the Mach microkernel and the robust, stable environment of BSD Unix. It was designed to handle complex tasks smoothly while being incredibly reliable. The name XNU was given by its engineers at Next and stands for X is not Unix, highlighting its superior power and flexibility over Unix. But while Next Step and the XNU kernel were brilliant, the company struggled. By the early 90s, Next computers barely made a dent in the market. The company was on the edge of disappearing. But there was one thing that Next had that nobody else had: the powerful, stable XNU kernel. And in 1997, when Apple was on the brink of failure, it turned to Next for salvation. They didn't just want Steve Jobs back, they wanted Next Step in the XNU kernel. So Apple bought Next for just under $500 million and made a radical decision. They abandoned the outdated classic macOS, macOS 9, and even scrapped their failed attempt at creating a more modern OS, dubbed Copeland at the time, and built their entire future on top of the hidden gem that was Next Step, which, of course, was built on top of the XNU kernel. It was first used by Apple in 2001 with the first version of macOS 10, Cheetah. Now do you see where the X comes from? XNU, Next Step. Visually, Cheetah looked a lot like classic macOS, but underneath the hood, it was little more than a reskinned version of the latest version of Next Step, known as OpenStep at the time. Even in modern macOS today, you can see Next Step's influence. The dock, terminal, finder, text edit, preview, spotlight, and mail all trace their lineage back to this revolutionary OS from the late 80s. You can actually use Next Step in your browser if you don't believe me. At infinitemac.org, there are a number of Next Step emulators that allow you to see what the original OS was like. I'll put a link in the description. Let's take a look at the latest version, which was OpenStep 4.2. It even takes time to load up like it would have back in 97. Once you're in, you should see File Viewer, which is essentially a stone-aged finder. Notice that even the main folder on the computer is a house icon. Understand where the home folder on macOS comes from now? Double-click on Next Apps to see the default apps. Notice the preview app. Yep, it is that old. This is where it came from. I'll let you look through here on your own, but to demonstrate how groundbreaking this OS was at the time, take a look at Steve Jobs demoing Next Step in January of 1992. He showed how to send both images and voice memos through the Mail app.
Here we are at the Next computer. I want to show you what it's like to work in the Next computer's productivity environment. And we're going to use the Mail as the spine of our demo here. And I can even add voice annotation by clicking on what we call lip service. And I can record something. Hey, can you check this out and let me know what you think? Thanks. Bye. The recipient just simply clicks on these lips and plays the message.
It amazes me to see that these features were available and so easy to use at such an early point in computing history. It's no surprise then that with the release of macOS 10 in 2001, the XNU kernel was at the core of the OS and still remains there today.
We need the best operating system kernel technology in the world.
As macOS has evolved, XNU has remained steady, although it has been expanded many times over the years. Apple strengthened XNU by moving to a 64-bit architecture, making it faster and more efficient. Yet the core of XNU remained unchanged. When Apple released its own M1 chip in 2020, XNU took on a whole new set of challenges, managing the transition from Intel to ARM architecture, integrating new security protocols, and validating kernel extensions to adapt to Apple's new unified memory architecture. Even with this radical hardware shift, XNU has adapted and thrived, proving that Jobs' 1980s design was more than just advanced for the time, it was built to last. That same hybrid kernel, built by Next over three decades ago, still powers everything you use today, from your Mac to your iPhone. So why didn't Apple replace it when they rebranded to macOS? Because replacing a kernel isn't just a simple task. It's like trying to replace the foundation of a skyscraper while it's still standing. Get it wrong, and the entire structure can collapse. But the real reason that Apple didn't have to overhaul macOS from the ground up is because XNU has a legacy of strength. By combining the flexibility and lightweight nature of the Mach microkernel with the stability and power of BSD Unix, it's adaptable and reliable, stable enough to power desktops, yet versatile enough to handle mobile devices. That's why Apple stuck with it. Even when they removed the X from their branding, they didn't touch the core, because they didn't need to. Every major update, whether it's the introduction of a new file system, expanded security layers, or even hardware acceleration, is built on top of XNU. Apple didn't replace it, they reinforced it. So go ahead and type it into terminal. Uname space dash A. When you see that reference to XNU deep in your file system, remember, it's not just some old piece of code. It's the foundation that propelled Apple from a struggling underdog to a tech giant. It's the very same kernel that powered Next Step, then macOS 10, and now macOS. Apple may have dropped the X, but the X didn't drop macOS. XNU isn't the only reason Macs stand the test of time. Check out my deep dive into Apple's design secrets to find out why your Mac is built to last. Have fun flying on that modern Mac with that vintage kernel at the core. I'm Anson Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.